So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Senate President Scutari.
Thank you.
Colleagues applauded after Democrat Nick Scutari took the oath as New Jersey's brand new Senate president, signaling a major shift in leadership. Scutari succeeds Steve Sweeney, who ran the upper house for a solid decade. Scutari will preside with one less Democrat, but a 24-16 majority, and promised cooperation on priority items.
Good paying jobs, healthy and vibrant educational settings, and an economy resurrected from the worldwide pandemic. To my friends on the Republican side, I vow to be as bipartisan as possible, to work together to achieve what the people of New Jersey need, which is to find common sense solutions to the problems facing them each and every day.
Scutari did face opposition from Democrat Nia Gill, a member of the Black Caucus, who deplored the lack of diversity among Senate leadership.
When power is concentrated in the hands of the few, millions are disenfranchised, and the voices of the people we represent are silenced.
Scutari won in a voice vote. Fellow Democrat Craig Coughlin will also command a smaller 12-vote majority in the Assembly. Together, they'll face an immediate pandemic issue: how to approach Governor Murphy's declaration of another public health emergency after outgoing Senator Sweeney yanked bills that would have extended his emergency powers for 45 days. Legislators on both sides objected after Murphy unilaterally maintained he'd continue enforcing a school mask mandate.
Without consultation with the legislature, why pick that fight? Why not have that discussion? He might have been able to get the votes for it on the D side. He didn't. Democrat legislative leadership and other Democrats not in leadership were rightly pissed off and decided to pull the bills.
Republicans have long chafed about lack of input on Murphy's executive orders and mandates, from vaccinations to masks. They decried another emergency declaration.
And have us come back and do a more piecemeal piece of legislation or pieces of legislation that can get bipartisan votes. That would be treating us like a co-equal branch of government. Heaven forbid. And we'd be willing to work with them on some of these things.
Steve Oroho will now lead Senate Republicans, some swept in by furious constituents angered over mandates.
Overarching declarations. We're hearing from parents. We're hearing from many people. And unfortunately, it's dividing, obviously, a lot of different people. The feelings are extremely strong.
People know what's best for them and their families. Nobody should be making decisions for anybody but yourself and your family members. So we do disagree with the governor. We don't think we need any additional mandates.
That's what helped propel Ed Doerr into Sweeney's former seat, and he wants to see transparency.
It's real.
It's real. It's real. They've actually let me come in here and be a senator. I guess they can't change their mind now.
How do you feel about it?
I feel really good. I'm very honored to have this opportunity to serve the people.
Both sides say they want to focus on making New Jersey more affordable for middle-class residents, and they acknowledged a need for more civility, long a crusade by former Assembly Minority Leader John Bramnick, who took his Senate seat today.
Job one is to make sure the legislature debates these issues. We don't want one person making all the decisions, and I think the governor now understands that.
The governor, in his State of the State speech, says today the politicking ends and the governing begins. The Republican minority will demand to be part of that process. At the State House in Trenton, I'm Brenda Flanagan, NJ Spotlight News.